So on the revenue page, which is page 10 in the, so this is where we get our money from. The tuitions for regular students, we include students from Heartland who pay tuition to us. The administration has worked hard to woo those students as much as we can, because it brings in revenue without increasing our class sizes dramatically. We have also, the administration has also been pursuing programs with foreign students who are looking to come to our school, again, as tuition paying. The tuitions for special education students are students out of district who want to come to our school because we provide services that their home schools don't, and they pay that amount of tuition. The tuition also come into the BOAG program as well. So we bring in nearly $1 million in tuition from those three sources. Interest income, self-explanatory, rental income, self-explanatory, grid contract, the cell tower, and then there's an applied surplus carryover from last year to this year. Then we receive regional and technical transportation grants from the state, as well as the BOAG operating grant. So that's the total of our state revenue is $342,000. And then the assessment from the towns make up the difference. This is a graph that just, these next few graphs cover the population shifts between the four towns that come to Northwestern. This is the way it's looked over the last 5 years, 6 years. This is the change in attendance for between 2008 October and October 2009, which is the date that we use by statute for the assessment for the following year. You can see that everybody is going down except for Fort Norwood, who went up, and because everyone went down, they got sort of double hit. Just another graph that shows you that. This is what the assessment increase or decrease looks like. So from Hartford, it will be going down by $15,000. And again, it shows you what happens when you go up, everyone else goes down. That was the impact for me. That's just another graph that shows you the percentages of the population per town. So, a brief summary on my 23rd year. We have been able to reach this 1.75 increase by reducing staff, by maintaining current levels or reducing spending wherever possible. We have the elimination of replacement schedules, and that means that, you know, the sort of 5-year plan that you'd like to have in terms of looking at what building projects are coming up, what needs to be taken care of, we've sort of eliminated that schedule, understanding that at this point, we are building a budget year by year. It's the economic situation and our responsibility to be fiscally responsible has eliminated, for this moment, our ability to look forward in terms of being able to project what we'll be able to take care of. There are no new programs or initiatives being brought to the school except for those that we can find outside funding for through grants. The administration has worked hard to maximize that. Heavy cuts in equipment and infrastructure replacement, significant cuts in general supplies and textbooks, the unusual increase, we hope it's unusual anyway, the huge increase in health insurance, the increase in special education tuition, the fact that the administration and all at-will employees have voluntary health, they will all be frozen for next year in terms of their salaries. And as Dr. O'Reilly was saying earlier, those staff cuts we make with very heavy hearts. This is not a budget that we particularly like, but it is our best effort at coming up with a budget that minimizes the impact on students, maintains the programs to the best of our ability while recognizing the financial situation that all the towns are faced with, that individual taxpayers within those towns are faced with. And that's what we'll have. So the increase in the assessment is $170,000. We will have our final budget hearing at the high school on Monday, April 19th at 7:00. Our budget meeting will be held May 3rd, at the high school, at which point we will make the motion to go to referendum to be held on May 4th. The board is, understands that that is what significant portions of the taxpayers would prefer us to do, is to go to referendum, so we have agreed to do that this year as well. And now there are questions, unless you do, if you want to throw anything in there.
Yeah, very quickly, there have been some questions about what the impact is of this budget at Region 7, and there is an impact. We think it's relatively minimal, because Roger and others have really worked very, very hard on building administrators to try to figure out ways to try to minimize that. There is class size increase, there's no question about that. Two students, probably in certain classes. We're still trying to hold that down as quickly, as low as we can. There is a reduction in some programming, there's just no other way to get around it when you are laying off or ripping other staff, especially in the career arts area. So I'd say that it's at the minimal but important change, and we want to try to stop what we can and try to plateau that and go back at some day when things are better, because we recognize what's happening in our world.